right in front of it.
That day pummeled Oklahoma parents like debris from the EF5. Seven third graders died in their school. It was a first for us, a heart-stopping wake-up call.
May 19th, if someone would ask me, is our safe rooms important to have in every one of your sites? At that time, I think the belief would have been, no, I think we're good.
In the wake of that storm, the conversation started to change.
Oh gosh, that is a monster tornado.
Oklahoma schools looked to Joplin, Missouri, rebuilding with safe rooms after a deadly EF5 2 years before. We looked to the parents of those poor children, grieving, bonded, bravely speaking out for safety.
All they were offered for protection that day were their little hands over the back of their heads. That's what my daughter was offered.
It's preventable. I know it's costly. And it's not an overnight fix, but it's preventable. Kids should just be safe at school, everywhere.
And the truth is, everyone wants safe rooms. Who wouldn't want the safest place for children in a storm? The catch has always been how to pay for it.
We've got classrooms, we've got media centers, both.
And in Oklahoma, we found a way.
It's important, and I get that 100%.
In Moore, there were just two safe rooms in the district in 2013. In the past 5 years, they've built two dozen.
We made a lot of promises and commitments to make that happen, and we've done it. So very proud.
Superintendent Dr. Robert Romines used FEMA dollars, insurance money, donations, and a $100 million bond issue. The district will be 100% covered by next year. In Edmond and in Deer Creek, administrators are committed to building safe rooms in every new school. Since 2013, though, both districts have added safe rooms in older buildings, so all students have the same protection at school.
So what can we build that they need and spend a little bit more to have that add-on also serve a dual purpose as a shelter?
In the state's largest district, there were only five safe rooms in 2013, five out of 74 schools. In 2013, Oklahoma City Public Schools hadn't built a safe room in a decade. And worse, to save money, they'd started construction on new gymnasiums without a safe room component. Public outcry caused the school board to reverse course.
We want to send this back to the trust for the increase in the fees for the architectural firm to design the physical education building as a safe room.
Nichols Hills Elementary got the first, and since then, 27 more elementary school gyms have been built with a safe room. Three more will be complete by the end of the year. Putnam City had no safe rooms in 2013, none. Since then, they've added three at elementaries and a middle school that's nearly complete. They're adding a safe room locker room to the gym at PC High School. With 27 schools in the district, they've got a long way to go. And so Putnam City took a close look at what else they could do to protect students.
They shoot 2x4s that weigh 15 pounds at 100 miles an hour. If they don't break, then they are sufficiently strong to withstand a 250 mile per hour wind.
Engineers identified the safest place in every building, and in two elementaries, the district added FEMA-rated doors and windows to harden the structure.
This is a newer area, newer part of the building, strongly built, not built to withstand a tornado, not a safe room, but if we harden it, it's going to be much safer than any place else in the school would be.
Since the Moore tornado, almost every school district in the metro has added at least one safe room. Several small districts like Crooked Oak, Luther, and Deer Creek now have safe rooms in every building. Big districts have made progress too. 23 new safe rooms in Oklahoma City Public Schools, 24 in Moore, 13 in Edmond, 5 in Middell, 4 brand new safe rooms in Norman, 3 in Putnam City, and 2 in Mustang.
In 2013, El Reno Public Schools had zero, but today, because of their tenacity and willingness to get creative, they have a FEMA-rated shelter for every student.
There it is.
El Reno failed to pass a bond issue for schools in 2012, and remember in 2013, the May 31st tornado got dangerously close to their district.
Well, it certainly
always worried me as a principal of an elementary school that those buildings weren't as safe as they're supposed to be.
So school officials worked with the city to craft a new bond issue, a dual purpose, shelters for students and for the community, so everyone in El Reno has a safe place to go.
We're very fortunate that we had the city behind us with this whole thing. I'm very much in debt to our city for making this possible.
They are unlike almost all the other safe rooms around town, built mostly underground, unfurnished, open to the community, built in multiple locations with easy access for students at school. The entire district can get from the classroom to the safe room in 6 minutes.
Our parents feel like our kids are very safe, and our community feels like they have a place that they can go. I make sure that they're open whenever we have a situation that merits opening them.
Once again, Oklahomans prove we learned from the horror of that day. Those third graders did not die in vain. We are building safer schools because we know what can happen if we don't. Allie Meyer, Oklahoma's News 4.